academic here?
I'm an entrepreneur.
What was that word you just used?
What?
Say it again.
Entrepreneur. Is that how you say it?
Say it one more time, Karen.
Is you making fun of me or you just like the way I talk?
Well, I'm trying to see if you're saying the word right. I think the word is
Am I saying it right? Entrepreneur?
I think it's entrepreneur.
Okay, well, you said it for me.
Oh, my God. Are you in the
Yes, I didn't know you were going to pick me.
What is it?
I was supposed to be here.
Girl, but why would you have the camera facing your shower? So what do you want to do? You want to do it from the shower? How are you going to get out? We're going to see your ass fucking naked.
We're just going to start out with the most ratchetest shit I ever seen in my life.
How you going to? But I have to hang up. If I don't hang up, we're going
to
see.
This happens to me all the time. This is my third time. I've been trying for 2 years.
You've been trying for 2 years?
I'm in the shower and I don't have my phone on me.
Well, why do you always call me right before you go into the shower?
I've been watching you on my TV. I clean my whole room. I'm sorry.
Oh, my God. Well, I can talk to you via the shower, Karen. What's your name? Jack.
From Philadelphia.
Where are you calling us from?
40.
How old are you?
Two adult kids.
Do you have any kids?
I'm a grandma already.
How old are your kids?
23 and 21.
Okay.
Yes.
By the same man?
No.
Yeah, you ever been married? What you do for a living?
I have my own business.
Okay, well, what kind of man are you looking for?
Genuine guy, God-fearing. He definitely gotta be like, he can't be too like cocky, but he has to have confidence in himself. I don't like somebody that don't have confidence in themselves.
It doesn't matter what she says. You're in the shower and you're live and can't get out. Not too smart. Pass, guys. Pass.
All right, listen, I'm a go. But when you get out the shower, try to call the YouTube show. What's your name so I can know if you do the YouTube show? I definitely will pick you. Jacqueline. Well, go back in the shower. I'm not going to put your ass bucket naked in front of millions of people to watch right now. Are you
have the towel? I have to open the curtain to get the towel.
And that means you will see you naked, right? I'm a hang up. I was about to hold you hostage.
Okay, thank you.
In the shower. So she can't get out the shower until I hang up because she can't get the towel without opening the curtain. So if she can't hang up the phone because she's in the shower. So it's on me to disconnect her, or she has to stay in that shower as long as she's live.
I really don't know why, but I think I would let her ass stay in there. I think I just had to teach her a lesson. Yeah. You gonna stay in there.
Or unless he comes out bucket naked.
This is my son.
Your son?
My dog. I don't know if you can see him on the bottom.
No, we can't see him. I'm gonna let you go. I'm gonna let you go and get your life together. All right, bye, baby. Nicole,
hey, let me
right?
go get better light. Hold on. Y'all stay in here, okay?
Who are you talking to? to?
My kids.
Your name is Naquita, right?
Naquita.
Naquita.
Yes, Naquita, ma'am.
Where you call me from, sweetie?
Lenore, North Carolina.
North Carolina. You mentioned kids. How many kids do you have, baby girl?
I have four.
Four kids. How old are your children?
I have a 10-year-old, a 7-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 4-year-old.
They all by the same man?
No, ma'am.
How many men?
Three.
Why not with a 3-year-old dad?
He played too many games.
Okay. What about, does a 3-year-old dad and a 4-year-old have the same dad?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so why not with the
7-year-old? The 7-year-old and the 4-year-old have the same dad.
It amazes me how nonchalant all these modern women speak on having so many kids with multiple men. She has 4 kids, 3 baby daddies. And she speaks on as if, yeah, like, well, I guess everybody do, because everybody on here seem to have 4 and 5 kids. I don't know.
And I'm with the guy, yeah, the 4-year-old and the 7-year-old guy.
He got on the drugs and just started, he was really abusive and stuff like that. So I just packed up one day and left and just never looked back.
Okay. All right, Naquita, when was your last relationship?
2019.
You don't have to answer, but I'm going to ask, when's the last time you was intimate with someone?
About a month ago.
Does that guy have an option?
My baby daddy. It's my last baby daddy.
So this is the 3-year-old dad?
Yes, ma'am.
So for all you simps out there that love running out and trying to save all these women with all these kids, listen to what she says. The same thing we have been saying for years. They are still involved with the youngest child's father. She said it like it wasn't nothing. She just been with the father a month ago. And you aren't here trying to find a good man. See, something ain't right. This shit ain't clicking. It ain't clicking. Shit.
So this is why I always ask, people always say, why do I want to know the ages? Because normally, and I only ask this question if you guys have figured it out. Whenever you tell me children under five, I always ask, why didn't it work? Because it seems that if a child's under the age of 5, there could potentially be still sexual relations with the child's father. So a month ago, it was only 30 days ago, you know, your baby daddy's not going anywhere. This is a man that is a part of your life. So what would you say? Because you were saying a lot of things that were wise, and I was very impressed how much you have matured and seems as wiser you are. But for a man that's watching right now, he would take that as you still sleep with your baby daddy.
Right.
So what would be your response to that?
I mean, I don't have to, like, I would be willing to cut him off. Like, I don't have to sleep with him. I just kind of just comfortable. Like, up here is horrible. Men are horrible where I'm from. Like, it ain't no good men. So.
So there it is. No accountability. Just blame it on the man. He did it. You always do it, right? Blame it on the man.
Well, let me say this. I think this goes on the board for both, because I hear men say this about women, and obviously just said it about men. I think what we have to start being honest with is, are we attracting the person that we consider to be good, right? Yes, so ma'am. I'm not sure if I'm gonna say there's no good men, and I know for sure the saying is not true where there's no good women. I know so many great women, right? And I've seen both on the show, good and bad. I think what we have to start realizing is our true assessment and what we bring, and if what we consider to be good, are they willing to sign up for it? Because, you know, like a man to hear you, because I mean, listen, I mean, life happens, right? And I think we have to have more grace in that area of life happening. But the fact that you still see what your child's father shows that, okay, there's still some things you have to work on, because I understand that you're saying you don't have a lot of choices and it's your baby daddy. And I understand this is not just for women who's with their baby daddies. A lot of women have the notion of, I don't want to increase my body count. So I don't like him, but I'm still going to sleep with him because it's better to sleep with a guy I once slept with than a new guy. And that's I get the logic of that. But this is what men have said. You know, if you want to be a wife, and men, if you want to be a husband, maybe you can listen too. You have to act as such, right? And if these men are not options to be your husband and that's what you're seeking, then figure out a way to stop having sex with them. So you can really know that he's not even a sexual option. I know it's going to be difficult because every woman has needs, right? And you have a young child together. But if you want to meet somebody new, that's something that only you can make the decision for. And let me say this too. The road ain't easy, okay? Like, when you start saying, okay, I'm going to be very, very cautious of who I lay down with, you're really going to start to see, okay, who can you build a life with? Because I'm not saying tomorrow you're going to meet the perfect man and now you have sex. It might be months. It really might. It might be months before you meet a man that you can align yourself with, which means you may have to go without sex for a minute until that man shows up. Now, if you know yourself and you know you can't, that's on you, right? I can't say nothing to that. I can't say anything to that. But you also then have to own up to the fact that my sex drive was more important or I didn't have enough discipline to control that until I met the right man. Therefore, this is what I am dealing with. That's a more accurate assessment than there's no good men.
I understand.
Okay, got you. All right, baby girl. What are three flaws you have to work on?
I'm impatient. I do like to argue.
What the F? How do you fix your... How do you fix your mouth to sit there and say, I want to meet someone, but one of my flaws is I like to argue? Again, something's not up there. What? But see, y'all sisters, y'all keep blaming us. Look at this shit right here. Look at this. This is your creation.
And... Well, not necessarily like to argue. I'm just very, I feel like I'm a very defensive person. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I'm very defensive. And, trying to think, what's the third flaw? I guess me having three baby daddies would be one of my flaws.
Yeah. And the four kids. Let's not forget that. Don't forget.
I understand.
Hey, girl.
Hello.
I'm ready. Hey, I'm good enough.
You ready? I got to see your face all the way. It's your first time here? All right. Pull back a little bit, boo.
Sierra.
What's the name, honey? Sierra. I'm from New York. Where are you from? And why? How old are you?
I'm so tired. I'm 34.
Dang, that's a hard 34.
Atlanta.
Where are you calling us from? Atlanta.
Yep.
Wait, New York.
I live in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm. You live in Atlanta, okay. Sierra, Atlanta.
Yeah.
You have any children?
Five.
How many? Five kids. That's like the number. I've had so many women with five kids lately. How old are your children?
I got 2 3-year-olds, 2 7-year-olds, 1 11-year-old.
So you have twins twice. Okay. Are they all by the same man?
Three.
What is it that when women get five kids or have five kids, all of a sudden you want to leave your situation as if though there are men sitting around waiting to want to be fathers to five kids that's not his. Ain't nobody out here doing that. Y'all better stay with that, whoever taking care of you. Shit.
Man. Why you not with the twins' three-year-old father?
Well, you know, we live in the same house, but, you know, things happen. It's expensive. It's expensive.
Okay, wait. We're lagging, so I want to make sure they heard you because I needed to hear you. So this is Sierra Alanta, 34. She has five kids, a set of twins that are three, a set of twins that are seven, and an 11-year-old, all by different men. The three-year-old twins, you currently live with
them? I live in a house.
This is the most ratchetest thing I've ever heard.
We live in a house. Not right now.
So y'all not together. So, okay, remember, wait 7 seconds. So how do you live with your child's father who you're not with? Can you, wait, Sierra. You have to wait 7 seconds because we have a lag, okay? So I want you to explain to me, how do you live with one of your baby daddies, the three-year-old twins, but you guys are not together? Wait 7 seconds.
Because he doesn't like what I do for a living. Oh, my bad.
Well, I didn't get to that part. What do you do for a living?
I mean, well, what I'm doing. I use certain things. I use lightening cream on my skin. When we got together, you know, I looked a different way. He liked it, but he doesn't. He doesn't like that I use bleaching cream on my skin. You know, he tried, you know, he don't like it. He just doesn't like it. He doesn't like it. I feel like.
Sierra, now real quick. I just want to make sure we can move forward.
I am. You want to see? I am. I'm this my life. Time. Anybody know me know that. I am. I'm serious. Hold on. I'm laying in my bed because I didn't think you would call me, but look, I'm serious.
I didn't call you. You called me.
Come up.
Yeah, I selected you, but I didn't call you. Right. I answered the phone.
You're right.
Sierra, what do you do for a living? Wait 7 seconds.
I sell bleaching cream. And I'm.
You sell bleaching cream. Okay, Sierra, I have a very serious question. What kind of man you think is going to date you that knows that you still live with your baby daddy who you have three-year-old twins by? Wait 7 seconds.
Can I be honest? Niggas do it all the time. Why? What's the difference with me? They do it all the time. I swear to God. I bet you a good 50% of your women that slept with men in cars because they nigga live with a chick.
You are delusional.
So that don't got nothing to do with nothing. This is my life, not his. You come in here, I keep it funky with you. You like to ride, we gonna ride. And that's that. That's wrong?
Okay. I want to get that response. Leo. What's your zodiac sign, Sierra? So you sell bleaching cream. Okay, so this is Sierra, lives in ATL, but from New York. She sells bleaching cream. She has five kids, 34, a Leo. So Sierra, what kind of, and she has three different children's dads, but she has a set of twins that are three, and you live with that child's father. Do you guys have sex? Wait 7 seconds.
I mean, when he wants to, like, you know, he don't be wanting to do it like that. When he wants to.
So what are you looking for on my side here?
To be honest, somebody that likes me for who I am.
What is the goal? Do you have a relationship goal? Or do you want to just meet another guy you can kick it with? Like, what is your goal in meeting someone?
Enjoy my 30s.
So just looking for a man to have sex with outside of your child's father? So I'm asking you clearly.
Someone to have fun with. Fun to me does not
always
have to do with sex. I don't think fun and sex is the same.
So just describe it for me because I want to get a clear understanding of the type of guy you want to receive from my show. Wait 7 seconds.
Foreign black. Foreign black, Caribbean or African. one that makes more money than me. Somebody wants to invest into me. Yeah, that's what I want. Someone that likes to have fun. Fun doesn't mean sex. Go out to eat, drinks, vacation. You know, you don't got to spend a lot of money. You know, interested in the things that I watch on TV. Like to do things with kids. If he has kids, that's cool. I'm down with it. Just, you know what I mean? I can't knock nobody. They want to work with me, too. Work with me hand in hand.
So, is it your goal to eventually move out of your child's father's place, or you're going to...
Isn't he in a better place than where I said?
Where you live, and that's what it is. Wait, hold on. We have to wait because there's a lag, so I want to make sure we can hear you. So, we got to talk at separate times. So, I'm asking you now, is it your goal to eventually move out of your children's dad's house, and he has to be okay with that, or... You're not going anywhere.
I mean, if I'm like I said, you know, if my husband today say he find another girl.
Did she say husband?
Your husband?
I live with him, but we not together. You know, people live together.
Whoa, pause. I thought he was just your child's father. You're literally married?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, well, baby girl, you can't be married. I mean, only I let married couples
to come together as one.
Somebody, but
to come together
a whole different
as one?
Huh?
No.
Yeah, I've allowed that. I thought it was crazy that you were living with your child's father. I didn't know you guys were actually married.
That's what it is right now. That's what it is. That's what it is. I can't lie. If I lie, it'd be, you know.
I appreciate you being honest. So when you decide that you want to get a divorce and you're free in that way.
Thank you.
I ain't got the bonnet on today.
I remember you. You got the bonnet on your head, girl.
Because I need a man.
So, okay, listen. It is your choice, but you need a man. You want to keep the bonnet on your head? You can find it.
Heck no, that man going to want to get my hair done, Kendra. I also wanted to tell you that I love you.
I love you more. But wait, what did you say about the man getting your hair done?
Maybe he could get my hair done and I could take the bonnet off.
Oh, okay, so I understand the motivation. So the motivation behind this bonnet is I'm looking for a man that's going to pay to get my hair done.
Exactly. No, not like that, Kendra. Come on now. I'm in the house relaxing. Leave me alone, because you sound like Monique.
Well, hold on. You're not in the house. This is the thing. You in the house, but you're not really in the house. You in front of the world. So if you cool with it, I'm cool with it. But I think sometimes,
I ain't going to put no wig on for the whole world.
But girl, this is my job of the world.
Why can't I be me?
You can do you to the 10,000th degree. I just want to reconfirm that you're not in the house. You want... the internet in front of thousands of people. But if you cool, let's go.
Find me a man, please. Yeah, Miss Kendra, I don't had a bonnet on. You was talking about my bonnet last time.
That's right, you and my mom.
Yeah, yes, I am.
Okay, I know I remember you. I'm trying to think if I remember everything that I remember. You had a lot going on.
And I don't now, because... I'm back with my ex-husband.
Now, pay attention how she looked. Go back and look how she looked when she first appeared on Kendra's show. Bonnet and all. Now she's back with her ex-husband. She's all covered.
And get this. He's not even married to the first two wives no more. So that means I'm the boss. It's back.
Can I ask you a question about that? So when did you and your husband get back together?
It was like right after I talked to you. It was about last month.
Okay, have you guys seen each other yet?
I told you we can't until he gets the...
I don't remember everything. So what's the situation again?
He has to get his passport and all that. You know, we have to see each other again. You know, so the people will know that we're like not like scamming, because you know you got scammers out there.
When was the last time you saw your husband?
I can't. What you mean? When I was in Egypt.
Okay, so when I'm asking direct questions. When was the last time you saw your husband?
You don't remember. You just said that you remember me.
I'm sorry. I do not remember. That's why I'm asking. But see,
that's the problem, what? Kendra.
What's the problem?
Yeah, I'm getting ready to tell you. When the last time I saw him was when I was in Egypt in 2017. But see, when you ask people stuff, Kendra, don't get no attitude, okay?
Well, maybe, girl, because I'm getting an attitude with you because I have to ask you five questions five
because
times.
Because you said that you remember.
I know.
So
I
why
remember.
Would I keep
okay.
telling you?
Here, wait, hold on, real quick. I do not remember every detail. I do remember you.
All right, well,
hold on. If I'm asking
you,
what,
Philadelphia.
Hold on.
You know I'm from Philadelphia. You know I'm going to talk back to you.
What is going on here? What just happened?
Keep talking to you.
Well, I'm not going to talk back to you. So we're going to have a conversation or we're going to have a debate. It's up to you. We're having a conversation,
but your conversation.
The way the conversation works, if I don't
stop talking to people like they little.
I'm not
don't belittle nobody.
Like first of all,
you got a nasty attitude.
Hold on. What? I'm not treating you like you're little. I'm asking you questions because I didn't know.
I said you're belittling people when you talk like
that. Hold on, wait a minute. You're not going there with that.
Calm down.
Hold on.
Because you got the right one now. But I'm just telling you. The last time I saw my husband, I told you, was 2017.
Listen, I'm about to hang up on you. Do you want to have a conversation or not?
Don't hang up on me. Bye.
Oh, my goodness. Here's the deal.
Isn't it amazing how some of you women would take time out your day, go on a live show just to argue with the host. And now it's happening with the women. So you women ain't happy with no one. But I'm glad we get to see it now. So, peace. I'm out of here.